Radio check. Radio check.
Copy. You copy, copy.
We're getting ready. We want to catch the first light, so it might be epic.
Stormtroopers, l'attaque du petit matin.
This is sick. This is fucking sick.
Je sais pas si j'aime ça.
Je sais pas si t'aimes ça.
See them often, for wherever the crowd is, they are not. But from them come the few good paintings, the few good symphonies, the few good books. And from the best of the strange ones, perhaps nothing. They are their own paintings, their own books, their own music, their own work.
Haines, c'est une petite île de pêcheurs posée au milieu de tous les fjords et donc du coup ça reçoit beaucoup de précipitations et donc la mission cette année c'est de venir rider les plus beaux spines du monde et il n'y a qu'à Haines qu'on les trouve donc on est venu ici.
Thomas suggested we bring a skier that's also with the picture crew, Leo Trifair, new to Alaska.
Tom qui me téléphone et qui me propose de faire partie de cette mission. Et donc là, j'en revenais pas. Je faisais des bons tout seul dans mon salon. Je suis venu en Alaska pour une première découverte du voyage d'une vie.
Putain, c'était sûr que t'allais prendre une daube. Mec, on va crever là-dedans à deux, mec. Oh non.
None of that happened magically. None of that happened, without a lot of really good prior planning.
So right now I'm gonna cook some like energy ball, some bait, some almond, and walnut all together, like big ball.
Zach, il est en coloc dans cette maison-là. C'est devenu notre camp de base à Haines, là où le crew se retrouve et là où on a préparé tout le matos pour partir.
When I was here in my 2015 season, I was on a recon flight with Drake Olson. We were flying around and looking at a lot of different spine features that had formed up that year. And he was like, oh man, if you really want to see something that'll make you freak out, I got something to show you. And as soon as we came around that corner, although it was in the shade, it was one of the most absolutely stunning faces I had ever seen. And after seeing my reaction, the first thing Drake said, and you know what the best part is? The helis can't touch that anymore.
I hate the people. The fucking people. Goddamn human.
Drake Olson, the pilot. He was a race car driver. He won the Porsche Cup in 1985.
As Olson takes us into Indianapolis, first the 140 miles per hour right-hander, then the 120 mph left. Well, it should have been left. Then it fires up and Olson sets off for the pits.
Never saw the warning signs in these crazy times.
Here in Haines, there is nobody else that knows the mountains so intimately as Drake does.
Sans Drake, notre mission, elle est pas possible. C'est vraiment un personnage cru, tu vois, fort en caractère.
And it took Jeremy Jones to go in an airplane and make a film, and then everybody's like, holy shit, look at that, damn. Why didn't I think of that? It's like, yeah, why didn't you? Like, what the hell's wrong with you? This hiking skiing's been around forever. You have this form of transport, go.
Yeah, he's kind of the only guy doing it here. He's the only guy with the ski plane.
Stormtrooper, c'est une face mythique. Elle a été interdite des poses en hélicoptère il y a quelques années.
There's some people that just don't want anything to go on, and they write letters. They have lots of time on their hands, apparently. What's interesting is that it is out of the heli ski domain, and that allowed for your trip to happen. You guys could take your time, you could scout it and figure it out, and then go.
Bah, le plan là, c'est qu'il y a Zach qui demande s'il y en a un de nous qui est prêt pour voler maintenant, pour aller setup le camp avant que vous arriviez. Et moi, je suis prêt quoi.
Bah, c'est bien, hein, je veux passer une nuit solo sur le glacier.
Oh putain.
He was born for this.
Yeah.
He is the man for the job. Better than James Bond.
Drake, see you tomorrow?
I hope so.
You don't leave me alone, huh?
It's just gonna be me tonight. On Alaska, bitch! L'aventure commence! Yeah!
Et du coup, il y a Stormtroopers là-bas.
Yeah. Polenta, cacahuète.
Ça commence à cailler.
Ah, je devrais pas avoir froid.
Where's your fucking people?
Here they are.
No, all your people and all your shit.
It's all here in the RV.
It's in the RV? Well, bring it the fuck over here.
All right.
We're loading up 5-3 Charlie here and gonna go join Tomas so he's not all lonely on the glacier anymore.
Qu'est-ce que j'entends là? Un avion? Qu'est-ce que je vois là-bas? Oui! Ouais, c'est sûr, c'est eux. Vache en V!
Bon ben voilà, je suis venu tout seul! Trop cool!
Ah mon putain!
J'ai cette table d'attente là. Et...
T'as dû bien dormir mon salon.
Ouais.
Ça devait être la folie.
Ouais, grave.
Oh yeah. Dude, we got to take a look at Stormtroopers. It looks so good.
Yes, man. Like, better than
like,
what we saw.
Way better. Like the birch runs, like everything. Like I had to take my face away from the camera for a minute. I was like shooting photos while just looking at it. I was like, oh.
Sick, man. I'm stoked.
It looks so, so good. Stoked.
Sur la fin de la préparation de la grande tente, on a mis tout le campement et tout, nickel.
On va pas s'envoler. Ah zut, j'ai fait le trou trop tôt.
Now we're all here and I'm stoked.
thought we'd get to our main camp up high on the Four Winds Mountain up there, and very gorgeous scenery.
On était un poil loin de Stormtroopers, mais on l'avait quand même en vision. Et on était au paradis là-haut. On était au sommet d'un glacier avec une vision à 360 sur toutes les montagnes d'Alaska.
Un jour toute la journée. Il y a tellement d'heures de jour, je veux dire.
Et mec, il va faire jour toute la journée. Et il va faire ça nuit toute la nuit.
Le chamois
d'Alaska.
On n'est pas venu les mains dans les poches non plus.
Tu dois venir, mec.
Je confirme.
Le soleil est pas très loin, je pense. Premier petit déj avec les copains.
Bon pancake.
Gros pancake. Pancake master.
Tomorrow we go make the advance camp.
The
Wednesday.
Shitty thing is that there's mostly cloudy tomorrow.
So we kind of
but today is mostly cloudy and we can see really well. Like, I think it'll be good enough to travel, hopefully. And then it's going to be this in and out, clouds, whatever, fog in the morning, maybe, maybe not. Maybe it's low, maybe it's high. We just got to go up there and see what it looks like and be in position so when it is good, we're not sitting here at camp and going, oh fuck, we should be over there right now, oh yeah. No. So we get ready and then we go out tomorrow and then we're ready for the next three mornings. And if we run out of food, we come back here and wait for another window.
I am going to go bury a beacon.
All right. Okay. Don't tell us where.
Flag, just once. Okay, stand up, follow that arrow.
1.8.
Right now we're doing a little bit of beacon practice.
a kind of a spooky snowpack at the lower elevation, so it's always good to refresh no matter how many times you've done it.
Yeah, everyone's practicing, getting their skills refined so we can all be on point in the case of an unfortunate avalanche accident, but we're gonna avoid the avalanches at all costs.
Ça fait beaucoup de métal. Moi, je crois que ça va servir à quelque chose, hein, je crois. Mais j'attends que Tony m'explique parce que pour moi là, si tu dois chercher quelqu'un dans une crevasse, il est mal barré.
So, you dig the hole first to make a trench here because that's where the sling is gonna pull. You make sure that the ice axe is deep enough, and with the shovel
you put the blocks.
You put the blocks. So sometimes it's not really easy. And you lock the binder, guys.
All right.
Always lock the binders.
Je pense que là, t'es mort depuis un quart d'heure au moins. Ça m'a trop pété les couilles. Ces nœuds de merde là. Mais bon, faut bien le faire, mais c'est vraiment de la merde. Même lui, il se demandait à un moment, il était là, attends, comment on va faire?
C'est même pas un pays, c'est une planète. On est sur une micro-planète dans l'espace, perdue au fin fond de la galaxie. Il y a que des montagnes avec des spines de ouf partout. La planète Alaska, bro!
La face qu'on voit pas trop, qui est à gauche, qui est exposée nord-est, c'est la fameuse Stormtrooper. Et du coup, on voit le haut de ce qu'on veut rider avec Léo. Qui prend un peu la light en fin de journée, mais qui la prend surtout en début de journée, donc il va falloir se lever tôt. C'est loin et c'est big. Mais c'est l'objectif du trip, quoi. J'espère que ça va marcher.
That was a good one. Ready for mission. Ready, Thomas?
Allez, allez.
Yeah.
I personally saw those traverses and everything and was like, wow, you know, I don't care how heavy my backpack is, like, I am not carrying one of those sleds. And I just knew it'd be super entertaining to watch everybody haul those sleds up there and kind of sat back and watched the show, you know. It was hilarious.
No! Alors là, on peut pas être plus chargé, je crois. C'est comme ça que ça se putain de passe.
Premier eddy en passé. Je pense qu'on va bien en chier.
Well, the advanced camp was pretty much necessary in a lot of different ways. The distance between base camp and stormtroopers was just big enough that it's not like we couldn't do it in a day, but the fact that we had to be on those lines for first light, that was the biggest determining factor, you know. You know, we're all about nailing the light just perfect, being up there at the exact time, and if anything, you want to be early. So hauling our supplies up to the advanced base camp was absolutely necessary to get what we wanted when we wanted it.
When we first came up over the saddle there to the stormtroopers, you can feel it in your gut how steep it is. You know, of course, every angle you look at it looks differently, but every angle you look at this mountain, it looks steep.
Bon ben, ce matin on s'est levé à 4h et on était dans les nuages. Alors on s'est rendormi, on s'est levé à 6h et on était dans les nuages. Donc on sait pas trop ce qu'on fait là, on essaie d'écouter la météo sur la radio. Pas si facile que ça, hein, Stormtrooper.
Petit hot 1000.
Hey les gars.
Rapido. Yo.
On va se faire un méga igloo en bas, on peut tous rentrer dedans.
Où ça?
Tout en bas, dans la windmill.
Yes.
Là, il y a Zach qui dort, là.
J'ai oublié de prendre des chaussures pour 3 jours, alors j'ai que les chaussures de ski.
I'm gonna sleep in holes instead of the tent.
La grotta loca.
Camp's great, man. My bed is all set up. Really, really lush accommodations out here. Got a little bit of wind last night, but yeah, once you get on the other side, it's real nice. So tomorrow morning, we're just crossing our fingers.
Nice, man. Reality show.
Radio check, radio check.
Copy, do you copy, copy?
Out of here.
Cool.
Thank you for what?
And we're getting ready. We want to catch the first light, so it might be epic.
Stormtroopers, l'attaque du petit matin.
J'ai choisi une ligne tout en diagonale pour traverser les spines. J'ai cru que j'aurais pu pouvoir tout enchaîner, limite sauter peut-être d'un spine à l'autre et tout. Mais en fait, je me surestimais un petit peu dans mon ski et une fois arrivé dedans, bah, c'était pas du tout comme prévu, c'était beaucoup plus raide que prévu. Les spines à la traversée, c'était une bonne guerre. C'est tellement raide que tu passes plus de temps à t'accrocher au mur qui a joué avec. Ça m'a donné une bonne leçon dans mon ski.
Watching Leo do that was amazing. Like watching him traverse from spine to spine, overexposure and avoiding his slough, you know, with zero experience with that kind of stuff. Seeing his how he was cutting his teeth in Alaska for the first time on spines was pretty stunning, because most people have to kind of work their way up to doing things like that, and Leo deserves it, you know. He's an extremely talented skier.
Stormtroopers, on est peut-être les premiers à l'avoir fait à pied. Donc ça rajoute encore un petit quelque chose. Tu te dis, ben, yes.
It's unbelievable, you know, like it's... it's the best feeling in the world, man.
C'est sûr qu'après avoir vécu une expérience comme ça, je sens vraiment qu'on a... toucher quelque chose là avec Léo de fantastique, mais ça donne envie de revenir. Il y a des centaines voire des milliers de kilomètres carrés de montagne qui demandent juste à être aidés, donc à l'année prochaine, j'ai envie de dire.
Mais bon,
so intense.
Yeah,
wow, sick Tony, man.
Yeah.
Sickest day ever, seriously, man.
That's crazy. Definitely the best day of snowboarding.
Like, I recognize certain words you guys are saying, but then you say it just like we do English, where like you like blur like three things together, like
yeah.
And I'm like, if you were to say it like three things in a row,
we
the legend of the stormtroopers goes like this. A very fierce storm came through and made these mountains with snow. And then the rock decided to protrude into the sky just as eloquently. One man entered and he was never seen again. And then he arose from the mist and they called him the Stormtrooper.
Let's see if it's spelled that way.
I don't know.
I do think this is just the beginning. I think this is the start of something really cool, something we can keep sustainable for a long time, because there's absolutely no shortage of mountains, and there's definitely no shortage of stoke for any of us wanting to get out there and do that. So Stormtroopers is one that I'm definitely, it's a feather I'm going to keep in my hat for the rest of my life, you know. I think this is a trip that I'm never going to forget, certainly.